Nice. Thick as a baby's arm.
Lars, I can always count on you, can't I?
You know, we could really use guys like you and your men in our band. I mean, army.
I ain't much of a joiner, but I'll do anything if it pisses off Lion White. Drag your wounded up here before they die, and I'll heal them all.
All right, come see us in Bladehenge sometime. Got some new t-shirts coming in. I'll totally hook you up.
Alright, we're done with this area, and just like that, our army gets a little bit stronger. We now have secondary missions we can go check out. I believe this may have actually been updated a little bit earlier. You can complete these, as it says, to get extra fire tributes. Very useful if you're trying to upgrade things. I will show them off later, but not all of them, because they're all the same and it's kind of fucking boring. And that is actually one of the major complaints most people, including myself, have about this game, is that the secondary stuff is just... it's dumb. I mean, to be fair, it sucks. Other than that, the game's awesome, though, don't get me wrong. Just one of those things that, unfortunately, what's presented to you in commercials and box art and such really doesn't mesh quite well with what's actually in the game, so you sort of get a differing opinion. Oh, shit, first try. Nice. But yeah, you sort of build an opinion or God damn it! Why do I try to talk this late at night? You build a mental image of what the game should be, and I mean, even right now, you're playing it, and you're like, okay, cars, I get this. It's like God of War, you know, combos, magic, blah blah blah, and all this eventually goes away, and it becomes something totally different. Not totally different. It hybrids it sort of well, but. By the time it changes, most people just aren't expecting it. Okay, yeah, screw you. And there's another one. Oh, he ran away. Never mind. Alright, well, I'll just run over you and run away. How's that sound? Fantastic! I also have this really bad habit of just trying to drive off cliffs and it getting me to just go into stupid areas. Right. At least I didn't die. How the hell do you get out of here? Oh god damn it. The other thing to know is that you can't jump at all in this game. There's just no jump button. So you're sort of screwed when this kind of thing happens. I could always just reset, but I really don't want to do that. So instead, I say we do it like a man. Okay, not quite what I envisioned, but I'll take it. Also, while we're at it, I say we go visit the Metal Forge and see what we can get. I mean, it did say there was a new upgrade, so... maybe something worthwhile.
The Guardian of Metal welcomes you. Metal noise, blood and fire, tell me what you most desire.
It's pretty catchy.
How about some fighting secrets?
All right, so there are some extra special moves that we can gain here.
This one's a little fire. Get a little more bang from your lightning. Why not make them come to you?
All these are useful, but
pain comes in many flavors. very show.
This is kind of cool, but I say we go with the fire. Because fire is badass as hell.
On your lower back, he's a nice bonus. Keep the... These strings come with a free paint job, I should mention. The best strings for combat. That'll really get their attention. The best strings...
Well, they're at least in the top two.
Shouldn't be anything else here in the forge, but I kind of poke around for bits.
For your driving pleasure.
I think yes. There's some new effigies, but we'll deal with that stuff later.
Okay, see you later, Guardian of Metal.
Yeah, yeah.
Akanazi, always awesome. Also, just so you know, a little bit of trivia for you. Earlier, when we saw Emperor Deviculus, that was... can I move here? Oh, damn, I thought that was a cutscene. Deviculus is played by Tim Curry. Pretty damn famous guy. But originally he was going to be played by Ronnie James Dio, God rest his soul. And unfortunately one of the things is, you know, you don't mix your Sabbaths. If you have Ozzy in the game, you don't have Dio.
Yeah! Nice Thunderhawk, man. You make that badass heel-mobile yourself?
Hey, you about done?
Let me check that out.
So, when are you gonna tell us how you got hurt?
I'm not.
Why?
Because then you wouldn't let me go back and finish the job.
No, that's Lars. I like watching you fight.
All right. Meet me at the Razor Fields if you want to see some more. But please, don't tell Lars, okay?
Score.
You're a natural on that thing, man.
We were made for each other.
All right, so now that Lemmy's joined our crew,
that was a nice. Of mine.
Is there something in my... Let's actually take a look at our home base here, Ironhead's HQ. All around, there's a bunch of just crap. Holy hell. What's a mastodon? Skulls and shit. This is one of the last things I have yet to show you. This is what the game refers to as buried metal. Using the Relic Razor skill, as per normal, when you see those little thorns. You raise up a tablet from the Titans. And we just gained the song Rock Bottom by UFO. There are a whole bunch of these with a lot of hidden tracks, including the Cabbage Boy song from the very beginning of the game, in case you really want to hear Girlfriend again.
Hey, that spider lair wasn't so bad.
Yeah. Well, I've always found it to be really peaceful and relaxing.
That was not what I expected.
Hey, that spider lair wasn't so bad.
You're nuts, man.
That's more like what I expected. Lots of speaker cabinets and amps. Love the random lighting. It's just really cool. I love seeing this just crazy art style that doesn't make a goddamn lick of sense, but somehow works very well. Background of that shot of Bladehenge, you can see Mount Rockmore, where you can buy those effigies if you want of certain people. Yeah, whatever. It's kind of just a luxury. Anyways, that's it for this episode. Feel free to join me next time when we take a look at even more Brutal Legend. Catch you guys later.